I've done television, Kannada television, about 8-9 television shows. I've done 2 films. My previous short film won me a national award at the 66th NFA, a special mention. And I am the director of the Kannada film Dollu, which is currently in the debut feature competition, along with the official selection. And I'm very, very grateful to the jury members and the organizing committee.
Sir, being a Kannada film, it's a South Indian movie. And do you feel the Kannada movie or South Indian movie should be go in a north side movie style or something like that? Because all the Kannada movies are shot in a Kannadan style, right? South Indian style. So is there any chance of coming with the northern style in Kannada movies?
Now Kannada is going global. I'll tell you why. You might have heard of KGF. People are taking inspiration from a Kannada film. You know, it's reached heights. And this year in IFFI, they're playing 8 films. 4 homage and 4 in competition. I think this is the highest, where Kannada films have been played in IFFI. We're very grateful to the jury members, and this is a stepping stone for a Kannada film industry. See, cinema has no language barriers. Cinema itself is a language. A true cinema lover would watch the film, of course, with subtitles. They need to understand. And since subtitles are a mandatory thing all over the country right now, I'm sure by now, language is not a barrier. On OTT platforms, you find such beautiful Kannada films. So Kannada films already arrived, and the other language people better watch out.
And how do you got into the Dollu, like that folk dance you have found? So is there any childhood attention to that particular folk, or you just got the name from someone else?
No. So basically, personally, I really love percussions. Drums, tabla, mrudangam. I love the sound of percussion. So this one time during a government function, I happened to... So during, in Karnataka, in any function, any ceremony, the guests are welcomed by Dollu Kunita performers. So it's a very common sight in Karnataka, so especially in Bangalore as well. So this one time in this government event, I heard these Dollu Kunita performers perform, and at the same time I was looking for my next script. I had goosebumps all over my body because it is so beautiful. They wear such rich colors. It's very vibrant, the colors. And the drums sound so beautiful. And they dance along with the drum. They tie the drum along their waist, 8-10 people. And they dance in a synchronized manner. It's a visual treat and an audio treat. So I imagine, like, dude, if this is one angle of it, imagine if this was in a cinema hall, in a 5.1, in a 7.1. It would sound great, is what I thought. And it did sound great. It is clearly, we are in IFFI right now, so it's sounding well.
So from a actor to a director, from a stage actor to a film. So what actually you felt, like any changes or any difference in that film right now?
I always tell this to my friends from the industry. When you're acting, usually you are making someone else's dream a reality. You're either making a writer's dream a reality or a director's dream a reality. When you're a director, you're making your own dream a reality. So this is what I believe in, because I've acted in a lot of projects. So it was always used to be about what director used to tell me to do something, and I used to do it. I didn't get to do what I wanted to do. That made me take up direction, I think, for fiction. I've directed documentaries and corporate films. It became a little too monotonous for me. But fiction, you can create your own world. And you can live it. You can make it a reality. That's why direction, attracted me.
Apart from film, directory, all these cinematic things, do you have any other hobbies or any other thing that you apart from
I recently learned the guitar, I think. And it's not hitting my head right now, but I'm sure I do a lot of things. But the primary focus is films. When I'm not doing anything, I'm writing stories. So I write my own stories. So whenever I find time, I'm just writing stories. I research a lot of things. If I get to know a new topic, I research a lot about it. I can say this is what is my hobby.
Is there any particular message to the youth they are watching right now? Is there any particular message for the youth, upcoming youth, for the future life?
In fact, my film has one message in it. No matter where you are, no matter if you leave your village, your small town, for bigger pastures, for in Bangalore, Bombay, Hyderabad, you go wherever for better earning. Do it, it's good, but don't forget your roots. Don't forget the cultures that you grew up in. India is a culturally rich country. Every 100 kilometers, not 100, 50, every 50, 100 kilometers, there's a new language, there's a new dialect, there's a new culture, a new tradition. So I'm sure every person, every citizen of India will have some or the other relation or a background with art, with sound, with songs, music or dance, anything. So wherever you are, wherever you go, however you are, don't forget your roots. Go back to your villages for at least a couple of days. Go participate in your melas, your fields, your get-togethers. That is what I intend to say through myself and the youth as well.
Thank you so much.
Love your country. Love your country.
It's a pleasure to meet you.
Thank you so much. Thank you. Good.